Differential equations for JEE. Let's get those 4 marks in our pocket. Yes, differential equation ke topic se har saal ek 4 mark ka question zarur aata hai. And it is usually very, very simple. You would realize that as we solve all the past year questions. Now, before we begin, differential equation basically has these topics: finding order or degree of a differential equation, formation of a differential equation. But the most majorly asked concept is solution of a differential equation, by which we mean you can get 3 kind of forms: variable, separable, homogeneous, linear. Now, you would realize there would be few questions which are word problems. Doesn't matter, it would eventually boil down to one of these forms, and mostly it is this form. Now, the major concern: how do I identify which kind of differential equation is it? Matlab, kaise pata laga hai ki ye kaun si differential equation hai? Variable, separable, homogeneous or linear? If you already know how to identify, then you may skip the video till this part and get started with the questions. Here, what we apply is method of elimination. Jo nahi hai, usse hata do. Automatically, you will get jo hai. So that means, first of all, whatever, differential equation would always come in a very mixed form. Don't worry, always write it in the format dy by dx is whatever function it has become. Okay, so always write it in the form dy by dx is equal to whatever. Now, what is that whatever? First, try to see, is it homogeneous? Homogeneous means of uniform degree. Suppose my fx was xy plus x square upon y square. Then, this is an example of homogeneous. Why? These two have degree 2. This has degree 2. This has degree 2. So, the same degree for every term, homogeneous. You would start with the process. If it is not, cross it out. Next, just try and see, is it variable separable? Very simple. That means, suppose this fx was this time a function like sin x upon cos y. So, can you separate it out? That means all the terms containing y along with dy on one side and all the terms containing x with dx on the other side. So, you separate out the variables and solve. In case, even separation is not an option. You matlab aap separate out nahi kar sakte, even that is gone. So the only option you are left with is linear differential equation. Now, in order to know in detail what is variable and homogeneous, you can click at the I button. I already have full concept videos on it. Now, even your linear differential equation is of 2 types. So very simple, first nahi hai to second to hogi. So it would look like this. That means the moment you express your dy by dx is equal to some kind of function, you would realize that you can bring it to this format where p and q, they are either functions of x or they are some constant terms. Need not be together. Maybe one is a function of x and another is a constant. Maybe both of them are constants. Maybe both of them are functions of x. Basically, if it is dy by dx, so you have a y here and p and q are the functions of x or constants. So you would proceed accordingly. You would directly write the answer. You would first get the integrating factor. And then in the end, you would directly write the answer. Y into integrating factor is equal to q times integrating factor dx times, and you just integrate the right side, that would be the desired answer. And in case it is not even this form, then the next linear form is dx by dy plus rx equal to s, where if it is dx by dy, then it is x here and r and s would be obviously your functions of y or constants. So in this case also, your integrating factor you would find and the final answer would be this. This time, since r and s are functions of y or constants, so we are doing with respect to dy. Here, p and q were functions of x or constants, so we were integrating with respect to x. Let me know in the comment section below if you want a separate detailed video for linear differential equation. And for now, let's roll. So coming to JEE Mains 2018, let y is equal to yx be solution of a differential equation, and the differential equation is given to be this way. Okay, then you have to, if you are given y of pi by 2 is 0, this is just another way of saying that if x is pi by 2, your y is 0. So just another way. Then what is y at pi by 6? That means what is the value of y when x is pi by 6? Okay, so basically you have to solve this differential equation. As I just mentioned, express everything in terms of dy by dx only. So for that, I need to divide throughout with sin x. So here we get dy by dx plus y cos x upon sin x makes it cot x is equal to 4x upon sin x, that makes it 4x cosecant x. Now this is one of the forms which you just saw, that means it resembles dy by dx plus py is equal to q, where p is cot x, q is 4x cosecant x. Your integrating factor is equal to e raised to power this p, and you do it with respect to x. So this is e raised to power cot x dx. The integral is e raised to power log mod sin x, which is only sin x. Okay, now this is ix, so the solution would simply be y into the integrating factor is equal to integral of 4x cosecant x into sin x dx. So that means when I solve on my right hand side, cosecant x and sin x, they cancel out. They are reciprocals of each other. Integral of x is x square by 2 plus c. So this is y sin x is equal to 2x square plus c. Now you are given when x is pi by 2, your y is a 0. So if I put the values here, y is 0 into sin pi by 2 is anyway 1. So 0 on the left into 2x square makes it pi square by 4 plus c. This means my c is minus pi square by 2. So my solution would look like y sin x is equal to 2x square minus pi square by 2. Now the moment you put x equal to pi by 6 over here, so y sin pi by 6 means sine of 30 degrees is half. So y into half is equal to twice of x square is pi square by, if it's 6, so it is 36 here, minus pi square by 2. So let's simplify this. So y is equal to minus 8 pi square by 9. Bingo, that means second option is your answer. Trust me, right now I'm explaining each and every step. When you solve on your own, it does not take more than 2 minutes. Okay, coming to JEE Mains 2017, the question, again a differential equation. You are given y of 0 is 1. That means when x is 0, y is 1. You have to find what is y of pi by 2. So the very first thing we do is we separate these out, right? Now certainly this is not homogeneous differential equation. Is it variable separable? Well, yes, I think so. You see your dy, you can take this y plus 1 here, minus, I'm left with cos x upon 2 plus sin x, and I can move this dx on the other side, and ta-da, we have separated out the variables. Now I can mentally integrate. How am I so quick? You can check out the I button for integrations playlist. Okay, so this gives us log of mod y plus 1 is equal to minus log mod of 2 plus sin x is equal to a plus log c. Why did I say log c? All those things I have discussed under differential equation. It is basically for better simplification. So if I bring my log to the right, I get log of y plus 1 plus log of 2 plus sin x is equal to log c, right? Now, this is all this is only to explain you. I would have from this step directly written y plus 1 into 2 plus sin x is equal to c, making use of properties of logs. In order to check the properties of logs, you can click on the I button. I have an exclusive video on logarithms for competitive exams. Okay, so once you get this, now if your x is 0, your y is 1. So that makes it 2 here. 2 plus sine 0 is anyway a 0. So c makes it 4. That means my final answer is y plus 1 into 2 plus sine x is equal to 4. But we want to know what is the value of y when x is pi by 2. So let's plug in x as pi by 2. So sine pi by 2 is 1. This means y plus 1 is equal to 4 upon 3, which means y is equal to 1 by 3. And yes, that's your first option. Please make a note. Okay, now coming to question 3. If a curve y is equal to fx passes through the point 1, minus 1 and satisfies this differential equation, then what is f of minus half? Now the first thing we do is we express it as dy by dx is equal to y into 1 plus xy upon x. Now, as you can clearly see, this is not homogeneous for the reason if I multiply, this is y by x plus y square. So, not homogeneous, it cannot be separate, it cannot be separated out in terms of variables. I would try the linear. It says dy by dx plus py is equal to q, where p and q should be functions of x or constants. So, even if I try to reduce it to this form, this is plus minus 1 by x times y is equal to y square. Not possible, because p is minus 1 by x, a function of x, but q is a function of y. And the other form, dx by dy plus rx is equal to s, also fails here. Everything has failed. Don't worry, your logic is still with you. So all you do is just open this bracket. This is y dx plus xy square dx is equal to x dy. Okay, I bring this term on my left and I take this term to my right. So y dx minus x dy is equal to minus xy square into dx. Now I divide it with y square. So y dx minus x dy upon y square is equal to minus x dx. If you try and visualize, this is nothing but d of x by y. Yes, it is just the quotient rule of x by y. When you try applying, this is y square, derivative of this, so dx into the denominator as it is minus x as it is into derivative of y. So the moment you do this, now in order to get rid of this d, you integrate both sides. So x by y is equal to integral of minus x dx, which will be minus x square by 2 plus c. That's your answer. Now the point, now this curve passes through 1 comma minus 1. So that means when x is 1, y is minus 1. Substituting it here, I get minus 1 is equal to minus, this becomes 1 by 2 plus c, which means my c, if I take it over here, is minus half. Therefore, the equation is x by y is equal to minus x square by 2 minus half. Now, you have to find what is the value of f minus half. It is extremely simple. Just put your x as minus half. So this makes it minus half is equal to, this would be minus 1 upon 4 into 2 minus half. So on simplifying this, I can take this minus sign common. So this would be 1 plus 4. Okay. Now this negative signs, they get cancelled. You are left with 1 upon 2y is equal to 5 by 8. So from here, your y is equal to 4 by 5, and bingo, the fourth part is the answer. Be very, very careful with the plus or minus sign, because you know the options are very similar looking. Please make a note. Now moving to question number 4, JEE Mains 2014. The question says, let the population of rabbits surviving at a time t is given by this equation. Okay, P of 0 is 100. That means when your time is 0 or at the initial time, the population is 100. What is the general population at time t? Now, a very basic thing. If this t and pt confuse you, simply replace t with x and p of t with y. So, now the differential equation becomes dy by dx is equal to half y minus 200. As you can very conveniently see, this can be a part of your linear differential equation. So dy by dx plus I can write minus half y is equal to minus 200. So the first kind of linear differential equation where p is minus half, q is minus 200, both constants, excellent for us. Now integrating factor is simply e raised to power and you will have minus half dx, that gives us e raised to power minus x by 2. So the solution is y into e to the power minus x by 2 is equal to integral of minus 200 into e to the power minus x by 2 dx. Please remember once again, if it is dy by dx and y here, these have to be constants or functions of x and everything is then, all the integration is done in terms of dx. Okay, so on solving this side, this is, on solving the right hand side, this will be minus 200 being a constant, e raised to power minus x by 2 upon minus half plus c. So our differential equation would look like, now when the time is 0, population is 100. In short, when x is 0, y is 100. So 100 into e to the power 0 is equal to 400 into e to the power 0 plus c. This gives us c as minus 300. So my differential equation becomes y into e to the power minus x by 2 is equal to 400 into e to the power minus x by 2 minus 300. Now the question says, what is p of t? Now I can divide throughout with e to the power minus x by 2. So this becomes y is equal to 400, because these two will get cancelled, minus 300, and this upon e to the power minus x by 2 when goes up becomes e to the power x by 2. Now do not forget that you had assumed t to be x and p of t to be y. So they are asking for p of t. You will say p of t is 400 minus 300 into e raised to power t by 2, and that's the very first option. Please make a note. Now coming to the fifth one, JEE Mains 2013. Very complicated looking but very simple. At present, a firm is manufacturing 2000 items. It is estimated the rate of change of production P with respect to additional number of workers is X, is given by this differential equation. Now just don't think this differential equation is linear. Reason being, this is root X, not X. Anyway, you know the moment you separate it out, this is 100 minus 12 root X into dx. This becomes your variable separable form. Then just integrate them separately. This is p is equal to 100x minus 12x raised to power 3 by 2 plus c. Okay, this x raised to power 3 by 2 would be upon 3 by 2. So this means p is equal to 100x minus, this bit gets cancelled and when it goes up, this becomes 8 into x raised to power 3 by 2 plus c. Now you are given, at present a firm is manufacturing 2000 items. At present means when no additional workers are required. So when x is 0, p is 2000. So this becomes 0, this becomes 0. So c becomes 2000. That means your solution is p is equal to 100x minus 8x raised to power 3 by 2 plus 2000. Now the question says, if the firm has 25 new workers, find P or find the new production. Okay, so then our X is 25, your P is 100 into 25 minus 8 into 25, which I can write as 5 square raised to power 3 by 2 plus 2000. This gets cancelled, okay, 2500, this would be 8 into 5 cube is 125, 125 into 8 would be 1000. So minus 1000 plus 2000. This makes it 3500 and bingo. That's your answer. I have done my smart work. Now it's your turn. So do it yourself question, which came in JEE Mains 2015. The question says, if yx is a solution of a differential equation, this is the differential equation, you have to find y of e. That means you basically have to solve this differential equation and then substitute x as e and get these answers. Very, very simple hint chahiye. It's as simple as that. The moment you divide with x log x, you will realize this is linear differential equation. Now, I zip up my mouth, you start working. I hope you guys enjoyed this session. If yes, then make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Share it with all the people around you. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that so far. It's absolutely free. And when you do that, don't forget to hit the notification bell. Also, keep commenting in the section below. Did you enjoy the video? And what is the next topic that you want? I would see you with the new exciting one very, very soon. Until then, bye-bye.